one high school junior over at Bloomfield Hills High School is doing just that. Joining us now on the Oakland County MegaCast is Andrew Zupancic. He is taking part in a project called the Porch Pantry. Andrew, thanks for being with us. Tell us about this project.
Yeah, thank you so much. So this project was started back in June, and we've done it a few times. And the idea is a no-contact food drive. So people sign up for the food drive, and we go to their houses with our volunteers. We pick up the food, and we bring it to the Lighthouse of Waterford.
So you're only a junior in high school. How did you come up with this and get involved?
So over quarantine, back around March, I'd been wanting to do a food drive for a long time. But with quarantine, and I have a history of lung issues, it was just too dangerous, and especially with COVID-19. So I had to get creative and come up with a new idea to be able to help people and get this food drive going. And that's how Project Porch Pantry was born. It's a, like I said, a no-contact food drive. And the idea, again, we had to find a way to have no contact at all. And setting up, there's a lot that goes into it. But basically, it was very helpful to have my family supporting it too throughout this entire process.
And how were you able to get volunteers, and how many do you have?
So volunteers are coming mainly from word of mouth and from spreading it through different posters. And I've partnered with Stuco this time around, student leadership with the Bloomfield Hills High School. And we have around 45 people working around the clock to help PR this project and help get as many people as we can to sign up.
45 people, that's a lot to organize. What have you learned personally from this project?
For me, this project has been so amazing. Going back to quarantine, and even now, you know, mental health is a huge issue. And for me, it was a difficult time. And this project kind of fueled me and kept me going during these difficult times. And it shows that the most amazing part of this project is seeing the community come together to form such an amazing project and to help so many people who are in dire need, especially during COVID.
Yeah, and have you been able to talk with some of the people that have received, you know, the food? And what's that been like, if you have?
Unfortunately, no. I'm hoping to this time around. I have talked with those at Lighthouse who are receiving the food to distribute, and they have just been so grateful for the food we have been able to donate. And we actually are in contact right now because we are expecting a lot more people than last time. So there is going to be a large influx, and we're hoping they're prepared.
Andrew Zupancic with us here on the Oakland County MegaCast. He is a junior over at Bloomfield Hills High School and also a part of the Project Porch Pantry. So you're doing your third food drive right now. Do you think this is something that will continue post-pandemic?
I do. I really do. And part of the amazing thing about it is the convenience that the project has. You know, instead of people having to go out and bring food, they can just leave it on their porch and we'll take care of the rest and we'll get it to where it needs to go.
So if someone wants to participate and donate, how can they do that? And do you need certain food items?
You can go to projectporchpantry.com. You'll find all our information about how to sign up and how the process works. And you will also see a list of food. Some of the common ones are canned food, boxed food such as noodles, and they're also accepting diapers and other baby supplies. Right now, especially too, if you have possibly Thanksgiving food such as pumpkin pie filling, that's what they're also trying to focus on so they can have great Thanksgiving meals for those in need.
That is so awesome. Hey, Andrew, you are a junior, so I'm guessing you're remote right now for school?
Yes.
What's this been like for you to try to go to high school and be remote?
Well, we started off remote. We went to hybrid, which is half the week we're there, half the week we're not. And now we're back to remote. And part of the most difficult part for me is I'm a very social person, and not being to interact with my friends the same way I'm used to, it's so hard. And also regarding student leadership, that is something I'm heavily passionate about. and we can't plan events right now. We can't do HOCO. We can't do a lot of the fundraisers or student appreciation we want to. So this entire thing has been so difficult for me. But my teachers are amazing, and they're trying to keep us together as a community, and they're the ones who are really helping me through.
That's good to hear and good to know. Tyler, before we let Andrew go, anything that you want to ask him?
Yes, if people would like to find more information or get in contact with you or others on Project Porch Pantry to get more information, to let you know they'd like to donate if they're in the Bloomfield Hills area or if they're in the West Bloomfield area or if they're not even, how can they get in contact and get more information on this?
So once again, you can go to the website projectporchpantry.com, or you can call at 248-672-6996. And again, on our website is all the information you'll need if you want to sign up, or if you don't want to necessarily donate items, you can also donate directly to the Lighthouse, which all that money will again go to buying food for those in need.
You know, Andrew, I know that you started this wanting to help others, but I will say you're only a junior, but college application time will be here before you know it. And a lot of colleges are going to want you for being able to do things like this.
Yeah, I'm hopeful. And the last thing I want to say is the amazing thing about this project is it is so versatile that anyone can do it in any area. So if you would like to sponsor one of these in your area, again, you can reach out on the website. You'll find our Gmail. And we can set up what we have in Bloomfield directly in your area.
And knowing that, what advice would you give to other students who are thinking they want to do something, but they don't know how to get it from the thought process into reality?
It takes time and it takes a lot of effort, but the reward of helping others is so incredible. And my hope is that your school district too will also be very supporting in helping PR and helping spread the word about your project. So if you have an idea, go for it. If you can help others, pursue it. It's so important and it's so helpful.
And you get something out of it as well. Andrew, thank you so much for being with us here on the Oakland County Megacast.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
The next food drive, we'd love to have you back on so you can share some of your experience as well. That'd be great.
All right.